Hi everyone, in this video let's talk about losartan potassium. Losartan is one of the angiotensin 2 receptor blockers, commonly known as ARB. This drug is prepared in the form of its salt potassium. It is available as tablets in different strengths such as 25 mg, 50 mg and 100 mg. The drug name losartan is made up of two phrases. The first is the prefix LO, which signifies it lowers your blood pressure. The suffix is sartan, which simply indicates it is an angiotensin receptor blocker. We can easily remember this suffix with a simple trick. The letter S indicates selective, A indicates angiotensin 2, RT indicates receptor, and AN indicates antagonist. Therefore, sartan is a selective angiotensin 2 receptor antagonist. Here the term antagonist is also commonly called as blocker. Therefore, it is simply an angiotensin receptor blocker. Before taking losartan potassium, you should know important facts. What are the clinical use of this medication? And how does it work? What is the dosage? And what are the important side effects of losartan? All these are essential to know. So, in this video, we are going to cover these important points about losartan potassium. First of all, let us see the clinical uses. Losartan can be given for the treatment of hypertension. It can be used in this condition as monotherapy, as a single drug. Otherwise, it can be combined as a combination therapy, where this medication can be combined with other drugs like diuretics. Among them, hydrochlorothiazide is a well-known and commonly used. The second clinical use is in stroke management. In people with hypertension for longer years, the risk of developing left ventricular hypertrophy may be higher. It is an increased growth of left ventricular muscle that results in contracting the raise in blood pressure. When your blood pressure is very high, it offers a high resistance to blood flow. To counter this resistance, your left ventricle tries to pump the blood with more force. For this purpose, ventricular wall thickness is increased, leading to hypertrophy. However, it decreases the cardiac functionality and reduces the volume of blood ejected. For such people, the risk of stroke may be enhanced. In order to minimize the risk of stroke, losartan can be given. It reduces the blood pressure and improves the blood flow due to vasodilation. It can also be used in conditions like diabetic nephropathy. It is a kidney disease with decreased renal functionality, particularly observed in diabetic people. Hypertension is one of the most important risk factors for the development of this condition. In such people, serum creatinine levels are elevated due to reduced renal functionality. Since losartan can reduce blood pressure and increase vasodilation, it reduces the risk of nephropathy in diabetic people. It can lower serum creatinine levels and improve kidney function. That's why it can be used in the management of diabetic nephropathy. What is the dosage? For the treatment of hypertension, losartan can be started at a dose of 50 mg given once daily. And the dose can also be escalated to 100 mg. It is a maximum dose that can be used for the people with severe hypertension. However, it can be used at a low dose in a few conditions. It can be started at a low dose of 25 mg for people with hepatic impairment. In stroke management as well as in the diabetic nephropathy, losartan is started at an initial dose of 50 mg given once daily. The maximum dose is 100 mg. Stroke management involves so many types of medications and requires multiple drug treatments. Likewise, losartan may be combined with diuretics like hydrochlorothiazide at an initial dose of 12.5 mg. Both losartan and hydrochlorothiazide can be combined as a single tablet for ease of administration. How does it work? Losartan blocks the actions of angiotensin 2 receptors. Angiotensin 2 receptors can be classified into two subtypes, AT1 and AT2. Here, losartan acts on subtype 1, which is denoted as AT1. It should not be confused with a receptor for angiotensin 1. Instead, it is a receptor for angiotensin 2 with subtype 1. These AT1 receptors are located at different targets like blood vessels, adrenal glands, and the heart. On the blood vessels, angiotensin II can produce vascular constriction by activating these receptors. From the adrenal gland, it can increase the secretion of aldosterone. On the heart, it increases the ventricular wall thickness, leading to cardiac hypertrophy. The action of angiotensin II on the blood vessels is more important. On the blood vessels, 81 receptors are located. These are G-protein coupled receptors. Angiotensin II binds to these receptors, resulting in their activation. Consequently, it releases a few mediators like IP3, inositol triphosphate, and DAG, diacylglycerol. These two mediators are responsible for increased intracellular calcium levels, which produce vasoconstriction. In this way, blood vessels are constricted by the action of angiotensin II. However, this action is blocked by losartan. Losartan selectively blocks 81 receptors. In the presence of losartan, angiotensin II cannot bind and activate these receptors. This prevents vasoconstriction. As there is no contraction, blood vessels are more dilated, leading to a decrease in blood pressure. In this way, losartan improves the functions of many organs and reduces the risk of cardiovascular complications. The next one is combinations. Losartan can be combined with other drugs, particularly diuretics. It can be combined with a few diuretics like thiazides. Among them, hydrochlorothiazide is commonly used. For example, losartan 50 mg can be combined with 12.5 mg of hydrochlorothiazide. Similarly, 100 mg of losartan can be combined with 25 mg of hydrochlorothiazide for people who need more control over their blood pressure. And the diuretic is chlorothalidone, which is a thiazide-like diuretic. It can be combined with losartan at two doses, 6.25 mg and 12.5 mg. Losartan can also be combined with other drugs like calcium channel blockers, which are commonly known as CCBs. For example, losartan 50 mg is combined with amlodipine 5 mg. Common side effects. Losartan mainly produces hypotension as an important side effect. This hypotension results in a drop in blood pressure, leading to various symptoms like dizziness, lightheadedness, and blurred vision. It can also produce some fatigue and weakness. Other side effects mainly include upper respiratory tract infections like stuffy nose and common cold-like symptoms. It can also increase back pain in a few people. A few other side effects of losartan are related to its water retention capacity. Because of vasodilation, it increases the retention of more water in the body. In the long term, it may cause ankle swelling as well as puffy faces. It can even produce some abdominal swelling. Now let us see the precautions of losartan. This medication can increase serum potassium levels, which is more important as it may result in a few complications. So serum potassium level should be very closely monitored during therapy. If you observe any unexpected weakness, muscle cramps, muscle pain, chest pain, or palpitations, it may indicate an elevated levels of potassium in your body. Elevated levels of potassium can be observed with long-term use of losartan. However, it may be more pronounced with other conditions. For instance, potassium-sparing diuretics like amiloride can increase the potassium levels when they are combined with losartan. So they should be carefully used with this medication. Similarly, potassium supplements can also increase the risk when they are combined with losartan. Even potassium-rich foods like bananas, apricots, avocados, a few vegetables and nuts may also increase the serum potassium levels. So when losartan is used for longer periods, potassium-rich foods should be consumed at a moderate level. Lithium is one of the medications used for the treatment of bipolar disorder. Particularly, it can be used to control the manic phase, so it is called as anti-manic agent. Since losartan can affect renal functionality, it can reduce the excretion of lithium, which increases its levels within the body. It results in lithium toxicity. Therefore, lithium level should be checked after long-term use with losartan. In people with chronic kidney disease, congestive heart failure, or any other condition like renal artery stenosis, the role of renin angiotensin system is highly essential. In such people, losartan can reduce the function of renin angiotensin system by blocking the actions of angiotensin II. So if losartan is given to such people, it can precipitate acute kidney failure. That's when people with volume depletion or chronic kidney disease, losartan should be carefully used. Where should it be avoided? Losartan should be avoided by pregnant women. Just like other ARBs, it can produce fetal toxicity. It is common with many of these angiotensin receptor blockers. That's why losartan should be avoided by pregnant women or women liable to become pregnant within a few months. So that's all about this medication, losartan. I hope this video is useful to you. Thanks for watching this video.